watching Adrian Drake TV.
Adɔfoɔ me church obi bia eman akwaaba eba Adwenkyerɛ TV. Sɛ deɛ munim Adwenkyerɛ TV deɛ nsɛm ahodoɔ ɛkɔso wɔ ɔman Ghana mu ɛne wiase afa ne nyinaa na abri bia yɛde brɛ adɔfoɔ no ɔmohwɛ. Ai ɛyɛ yɛ nua Barbara Tome. Barbara ɔyɛ Ghana ni a ne kunu so yɛ Ghana ni ɔmo nyinaa wɔ US mem Orlando. Ab sebi Bema bufu ya ochun tuo si na iresu a obo ni tuo 7 times a Barbara befi mu ya. Eye 26 September, Saturday, ano mudi na ye eshishe su e Orlando anyamiandum e yen akwe ye ye. Ne are husem, abra nane papa e ridi tribute o nankasa trauma ane beyi. E no mu video ni e de brewi. Bemensu.
Others to acknowledge the presence of His Excellency, the Ambassador of Ghana to the United States, His Excellency Dr. Ajay Balfour, Bishop Perrin, other men of God. With the same token of respect and honor, I acknowledge the presence of everybody here. You're most welcome. I have with me here one of my very good friends, right from the military academy. He's Captain Joseph Che Nimako. He came from Chicago to support us in these hard times. Your Excellencies, distinguished guests, manners, ladies, gentlemen. My name is Captain Samson Hoponu Tomi, retired. I served with the Armed Forces of Ghana, that's in West Africa. Thereafter, I joined the United Nations International Civil Service. That is what I do now. That's where I belong now. I'm the father of Barbara Efia Famia Tommy, whose tragic death we all gathered here to mourn today. The Tommy family is honored by your presence, and we thank God for making it possible for you to be here or to participate in supporting us in this hard time. I still visualize my beautiful, elegant, cheerful, brilliant, humble, noble and above all, God-fearing daughter, Barbara. She had a passion for preaching, and she has been very instrumental in the church, enthusiastic about things of God. And I encourage her a lot to do that. She radiated a lot of light. She represented a lot of hope, opportunity, and promises for the Tommy family, the people she related with, and those she carried along. Since the 8th of September 2020, today, it's been a very difficult time for the Tommy family, home and abroad, for our friends, our loved ones. Very difficult time for us. The circumstances of Barbara's passing, I will describe as a struggle between light and darkness. That struggle, which was referred to in John chapter 1, verses 5, that darkness could not comprehend light. Darkness did not comprehend light. But at the end of the day, it's light that won. That is why I agreed with the earlier speakers. As a father, myself and Barbara, we've been very close. Most of the time, she will volunteer to pick me from the airport, and then we will start our chats. She would remind me, "Oh, you said you were going to do, you had this plan project you want to do, what, where have you got?" I didn't have enough time to do it, or I had to divert the resources to do something else. It's that you have changed your plans again. So she will be teasing me. Barbara is dearly loved and respected in the family. We respect her views. We really adore her. She has been there for everybody. And sometimes I even assign her roles to play. Okay, talk to this person, not to do this again, not to do that. She said, okay, she will say, I have done that for you. Well, today I'm aware I will no longer have these opportunities, these nice times I had with Barbara. Yes, I'm aware the devil came to steal, to kill, and to destroy. I'm also aware that another trajectory of the devil is wickedness, which is manifested through hatred, bitterness, jealousy, needless discrimination, and deviation from appropriate norms and principles as prescribed by God, by the good books of God. Wickedness manifested through hatred, bitterness, jealousy, needless discrimination, deviation from appropriate norms and principles prescribed by good books of God. That my innocent daughter Barbara, so harmless, so meek and mild, has become a victim, and her brilliant life, brilliant future is cut short for no tangible reason. Some people who knew Barbara way back home as a child, some officers, some friends, some relations ask, who wants to hurt that your daughter? Said Barbara, for what reason? They're simply referring to the naivety of Barbara. It's not only the Tommy family who's a victim. Our friends, our loved ones have become victims of these kinds of mindset and cruelty. I did not expect this fate for Barbara the way it happened. I can confirm that by her kind, peaceful nature, Barbara does not deserve this treatment, nor do we as a family. There are a few values that the Tommy family upholds dearly. We uphold respect for the life of others, respect for the dignity of others, humility, sincerity, integrity. And that is how we were brought up. The Tommy family has been brought up in that way. And that is, yes, and that is the kind of behavior we try to inculcate into our children. And Barbara upholds that dearly. That's one reason I cannot accept. I find it very difficult to cope with this. I need to emphasize that the Tommy family is a very peaceful family. We love people, we take care of people. You definitely don't need again You don't need a cane. You don't even need a shrub, not even a leaf, to communicate with us. Tell us what you think. Let's discuss it. That's how we believe in dialogue. So there was really no need for anybody to stalk Barbara, to hide around her office, and to gun her down. In fact, I don't wish this for anybody. I definitely don't wish for anybody. And I insist that this is sheer cruelty to Barbara. And it's a very severe injury to the family, to our friends, to our loved ones. It's a serious, grievous injury to the Tommy family, home and abroad. I don't know how to explain it. Barbara is an irreplaceable loss to the Tommy family, to our friends, our loved ones, those who have had time to really get to know her. An irreparable harm done to us as a family. It's a wound that I don't know when it will heal. It's a wound I do not know when it will heal for us. It's only God who knows. Worry about this. As a family, we shall continue to cherish Barbara. We shall continue to love Barbara. I still trust God. I have faith in God. My humble prayer is that God will comfort Barbara, will grant her peace wherever she is, until we meet again. I want to thank you all for your demonstrated love, for your kind support to the Tommy family. I sincerely thank you. It's a very difficult time for us, and I pray that may God richly bless you. Thank you very much.
For we are rehusema esi ye ewa Barbara Tommy ne ye nasi rehusema esi wasi ye mushe seni bema ejina injina eh ebi afa papa ye ni suo ebi afa neni so papa na asemba ko kan ni sey on we she ade we sey ema obibia owishi mo obibia na nyankopo nti no still oye strong no be koso na wasum nyame enye we ne bebu na pem e woni nyame a osum no ne ho adofo ya the link e be share video yesro ana afi so description box no won okwa no abe hu link ni funa video no eno so ho ma be hu bibia e koso e da se se abibia o hwe adventure tv e be so so be subscribe to channel na afi video no so
wa share na odofo bi so enye bi ahwe afi so na wa subscribe.